Greyhound News Network. This is Pope TV. And please stand for the Pledge of the Flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now, for a moment of silence.
Welcome to the Greyhound News Network. I'm Sydney Annis.
And I'm Kate Green.
And this is Pope TV. Congratulations to sophomore Tyler Wold, our student of the week. Tyler was nominated by Mrs. F, who described him as dedicated and going above and beyond in the classroom. Way to go, Tyler.
Ambassador applications for the 23-24 school year are open. To qualify, you must be a rising junior or senior who is kind and willing to wow the rising freshmen with Pope spirit. Applications can be found outside Miss Hebert's room in 103. Applications are due back on Friday, May 5th. Have any questions? Stop by and talk to either Miss Hebert or Miss Sims.
Let's go to our weekly weather report.
What's up, guys? It's Nick. I'm back with the weather report for this week. If you can see behind me, we see that it's going to be a pretty solid week. We got lows in the 40s to 50s range, highs going into 60s and 70s, hoping to get a little bit cooler during the weekend. The weekend looks like it's going to be a bit rainy, but as I see it right now, we might have a pretty sunny Saturday. So I'm looking forward to that. But I think overall, as we progress past the weekend, it's going to be pretty sunny, pretty nice, and it's going to be a pretty enjoyable week. That's all for the weather. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Nick.
Attention all seniors and juniors who are attending prom. Seniors, if you paid your junior dues, you already have your prom ticket, but all juniors need to purchase a ticket. Only seniors who did not pay junior dues must purchase a ticket. Today is the last day to purchase tickets on MyPayments Plus. Date tickets are $100 and the form from the Pope website must be filled out for guests who are not Pope students. Please turn in date forms and payments to room 118. If you have any questions, please see Miss Kelly or Miss Kitchens.
And now to the sports.
This is Kella
and Anna in the morning.
And now the sports.
Congratulations to senior Eli Overstreet. Eli was selected last week as the Cobb County Male Athlete of the Week.
The baseball team is in the Sweet 16 round of the state playoffs. Let's check in with Anthony for the latest highlights.
What's going on, Greyhounds? It's Anthony with your baseball report. On Monday, the guys destroyed Appalachia 12-2 to move on to the second round of playoffs. Jack Myers was 2-for-3 with a bomb and three RBIs. Kent Schmidt was 2-for-4 with an RBI. Cooper Orr was 2-for-4 with an RBI. Ethan Garrett pitched 5 innings with 6 strikeouts and a win on the mound. And Bryce Chapin hit a walk-off. The boys travel to Woodstock on Saturday. First game is at 1, and the second game will start 30 minutes after the end of game 1. Everyone needs to show out, make some noise, and support the guys. That's it from me. Back to the studio.
Good work, Ant.
On Monday, our soccer hounds played at home in the Elite 8 round of the state playoffs. Let's check in with Kent for the soccer report. What's the word, Kent?
What's up, Greyhounds? This is Kent with your soccer report. On Monday night, the Lady Hounds took down North Atlanta 1-0 to advance to the Final Four. The lone goal of the game was scored by Carly Oobs with 9.5 minutes left in the game. The girls played their Final Four game yesterday at Pope against Roswell, but we do not have the results as of now. Keep kicking some butt, girls. And as always, release the hounds. Back to the girls in the studio.
Great work, Kent.
Congratulations to the boys' tennis team. The guys beat Alatoona on Monday in the second round of the state playoffs 3-0. Next round, the guys will be playing at Marist on Monday. Good luck, tennis hounds.
The lacrosse teams competed Tuesday in the first round of their state playoffs. The girls played at Marist and the boys were at home against St. Pius. Let's check in with Hannah for the lacrosse report.
This is Hannah with the LAX report. The girls' lacrosse teams mashed Marist on Tuesday in the opening round of the state playoffs. On Friday, the girls travel to Creekview for their second round at 6. Keep scoring those goals, ladies. The boys' lacrosse team also played Tuesday night against St. Pius. It was a great night for the Hounds as they pounded Pius 11-5. Danny Harris scored a hat trick, and the Hounds now move on to round 2. The boys play tonight in the second round at Alpharetta at 6. Let's get ready to rumble! Good luck, lacrosse teams. That's all from me. Back to the studio.
Great work, Hannah.
Let's check in with William for the track and field report.
It's William with the track and field report. Last Monday, we saw the team finish up region with an impressive sweep on both the boys and girls teams. Chandler McDade finished first in the 110-meter hurdles, Chris Hayes first in the 200-meter dash, Gabby Key second in the 100-meter dash, Kristen McNeil second in the 400, and Carter Spohn third in the 800. Kelsey Fergalo, Kristen McNeil, Ramona Berna, and Zoe Gutman second in the 4x4-meter relay, Carter Spohn and Dermot Aloney first and second in the 16, Reagan Cochran, Chris Hayes, Alex Tashabi, and Daniel Robinson second in the 4x100-meter relay. Your boys won the overall meet, and the girls came in second. We look forward to seeing the results of sectionals tomorrow night. Great job to all the athletes who have competed so far. Back to you guys.
Keep up the good work, William.
And finally, do you love cheering for Pope in the student section at Pope events? Do you love dressing up for Spirit Days? Do you love Pope High School? Then you should apply to be an MC for the 2023-24 school year. All rising sophomores, juniors, and seniors can apply. Please go to room 313 for an application. Applications close today.
That's it for the sports. Back to you guys.
Thank you, guys.
Attention Pope students. Pope Football Boosters are hosting a t-shirt design competition for next year's Matt Hobby football game. Pause your screen and review the design requirements or scan the QR code for additional information and to submit your designs. Posters are hung around the school with the QR codes as well. The winning design gets a free t-shirt. Submissions close on Friday, May 12th, so get your designs in soon, Greyhounds.
Is everybody ready? Yeah. Is everybody excited?
For cabaret. Yeah.
I need more enthusiasm.
30th anniversary.
Are you looking for service hours? You can earn hours by setting up testing locations for AP exams. There are 6 different dates to choose from. You may work one day or all 6. Gather a group of friends or teammates to make the work more enjoyable. Please see Ms. White in room 105 to sign up.
Do you know Pope High School's local rapper, Young Sean? But do you know how he got here? At a young age, his grandma inspired his love for music. And because of that, he started his rapping career at age 9. And at the same age, he got his first collab in the music video Polo Horses by Trap House Music ENT. Sadly, at age 13, his biggest supporter, his grandma, passed on, and to honor her memory, he carries an image of her on his necklace to this day. But he still continues to create music and releases them on various platforms, such as Apple, Spotify, SoundCloud, Amazon, YouTube, and iHeartRadio. Now, his current inspiration is to motivate the youth. And that is Young Sean, The Beginnings.
It's time for our first period GNN Viewers of the Week.
Congratulations, Coach Clemens, Pastor GNN Viewers of the Week!
Are you rolling? All right, congratulations. Well, congratulations. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. I think this is my third, fourth year in a row. Appreciate it. Everybody say yay! Yay!
Did you know that 21.7 million children in the United States receive a free or reduced price lunch during the school year? For a lot of those children, school lunch is the only full meal they have every day. During the summer, that guaranteed meal goes away and millions of children go hungry or food insecure. How can you help? Donate dry and canned goods to our Must Ministries food drive now through May 11th. Bring all donations to your first period class. The first period with the most collected items will win a donut party the week of May 15th, sponsored by the POC Student Alliance. Every donation helps feed a child in need.
Did you know that the Greyhound News Network is always online for your viewing at www.greyhoundnews.net? Log in from your phone or at home 24/7.
We are the GNN. Thank you for watching the Greyhound News Network.
Have a great day, Greyhounds.